What was normal to have in 2010 but not 2020? Shake weights. It's funny because shake weights are one of the few, as seen on TV, products that actually did what they claimed and was a useful piece of workout equipment. Too bad it looked like a handjob practice machine. Wait, it wasn't an actual handjob practice? Cell phone with a physical keyboard. I miss the F out of my Rumor Touch. I miss my Sidekick ID. That thing was so cool. Silly bands. Those were the shit when I was in elementary school. You were considered cool. Aw yeah. I had hundreds of those. The glow-in-the-dark ones were the best. I thought you guys were talking about goofy musical bands. Right? Because I remember a period of bands coming out with some ridiculous names. Something weird like Unicorn Shoehorn, Bottom of the Shoe Bubblegum and the Amazing Carpet Brush, the Street Pebble Kicking Beer Brewers and Martin, Maroon 5. Things with mustaches on them. I remember I had a pair of shades that had mustaches on them and I thought they were so pimpin'. Also galaxy theme everything. Pimpin'. Now that's a word I haven't heard in a while. A still functioning flip phone with no access to the internet. You mean a flip phone with an internet button that made you freak out when you accidentally clicked it? That could get expensive real quick. Yeah dude, when you clicked that you knew your mom would beat the shit out of you for those 2 minutes you spent searching for lyrics of a song. Swine flu. Don't worry, we've got the next best thing. A landline. I have a landline because it comes with the cable and internet. I don't have a phone for it though. And I'd have to look in the phone book for my number, but it's there. I'm somebody now. Funny ringtones. Everyone had some ridiculous comedy ringtone for a couple of years there, and then in like 2011 we just mutually decided as a culture to keep our phones on vibrate. Except old people on trains. Bingly bong bong dingly dong dong deedly doo doo doo. We just mutually decided as a culture to keep our phones on vibrate. That's up there with the Magna Carta and the founding of the United Nations. The only actual proof of social contract theory, with the possible addition of NYC subway etiquette. A separate device for music from your cell phone. Still use my MP3 player, batteries for ages and I can grab it after 2 months and it still has 70% battery. No opinion on Donald Trump. Back in 2009-2010 I had a teacher who hated Trump because for some reason her son was obsessed with The Apprentice and would watch it religiously. She told us, every time I see his stupid face and stupid hair on the screen I want to jump out a window. I wonder where she is now. Probably below a window. A Nintendo Wii. I still see a lot of them, people didn't throw them out and a lot of the casuals never upgraded. Can confirm, I am a casual gamer, and I still have my 2009-ish Wii. I also never threw out my Super Nintendo from like 1997. But all of a sudden around 2014 all my friends got really into it for a minute saying how cool and old it was. Wow, you have to blow into the cartridge, lol, I figure eventually maybe the Wii will reach that point and it will become cool to have one. Only time will tell. A BlackBerry phone. Ping. Miss being able to text accurately in class without looking at my phone. Also, extremely satisfying feeling typing on BB keyboard. Edit, I'm not still in school, probably shouldn't have said, in class. Extremely relatable, BBM was great also. A large collection of DVDs. I still have a large collection of DVDs, a worrying number of them still unopened. I'm moving house at the moment. I have found a shocking number of Xbox games and Blu-rays with the shrink wrap still on. Worst thing is, they were all in a box that I'd found from when I last moved 2 years ago that was in the garage. At this point I should probably just get rid of them. Toilet paper and food on shelves. I visited a Walmart that was a half hour away from a major metropolitan area today. Toilet paper was wiped out, disinfectant wipes were out of stock, hand sanitizer was gone, and isopropyl alcohol was nowhere to be found. People are nuts. A headphone jack on my phone. I still have one. I'm never giving up my iPhone 6 if I can help it. A Facebook and Tumblr account you weren't ashamed of. Now it's all about Instagram or Twitter, and the consensus among younger people seems to be that Facebook is for boomers. Tumblr lost a ton of users after they were bought by Yahoo. Yahoo did what Yahoo does and fucked it up. It got sold to Verizon at a loss, and Verizon cracked down on all the lewd art. But they're somehow still limping along. Facebook is for boomers. I can understand this. Facebook was cool back 2004 when you needed a .edu email to sign up. It was new and superior to MySpace for keeping in touch with your old HS buddies who ended up out of state. All of a sudden one day you get a friend request from an aunt and middle school age cousin. It's like nope, enjoy your billions Zuckerberg, I'm out. Chains on your jeans. The e-boy, e-girl craze has actually popularized this again and it's almost more popular than it has been in almost a decade, somehow. A computer room. Similar to an office room where only one computer would be located, typically a desktop. Now everyone has their own laptops. Still got one. Granted, I'm a computer nerd with a rig. These are also out of schools now. I remember learning to touch type in 2010 in the school computer room. Rage comics. It's how I started Reddit. Same. My first submission was a stupid rage comic. All those Live Strong type landfill bracelets for everything. Landfill bracelets. Yes, this exactly. What an utter waste of silicone. A PSP. I have a PSP Go that I still use today. Perfect for emulating and it's pretty easy to find ISO of most PSP games. Just downloaded the PSP version of Castlevania, Symphony of the Night. A 2010 calendar. I don't know. Leftover 2010 calendars will perfectly match up all the weekends, days of the week with 2021. Season changes and holiday dates might be different, in cases where they are not based directly on calendar dates or the combination of calendar dates or days of the week. A laptop case you would put into your backpacks, shit build, but took like half of your bag's space. Now we have thin cushioned laptop backpacks that are perfect for laptops. Also, in 2010 I remember I used to own this toy, many people had it I'm pretty sure, but it was a walking cell phone. Most toys back then were basic plushies or everyday objects with faces on them. Nowadays we have toys like lightsabers and 1000 degree knives, yes I'm not kidding. Flip phone. We forget that it's really only been in the last few years that smartphones became ubiquitous. In 2010, smartphones were still just a rapidly rising class of phones that was not a majority of total phones sold. The issue of just what the dominant smartphone paradigm was going to be hadn't been fully settled on yet, with a wide variety of smartphone types and functionalities still being experimented with by a fairly wide variety of companies. Android was still a relative newcomer, iPhones were just reaching other carriers besides AT&T, which had exclusive rights until the iPhone 4, and RIM's BlackBerry was still the most widely sold smartphone available, with a dominant market share in the smartphone area that was about to fall off a cliff. Shucks, even Windows Mobile hadn't miserably failed yet and Microsoft was gearing up to release the sort of smartphone but not really kin, waving goodbye to about $1 billion as it did so. 1,000 bitcoins. I'm still kicking myself. Probably less than those of us who had them but left them on old machines or deleted the wallets. My brother-in-law is straight up a Bitcoin billionaire. All he has to do is find his Bitcoin wallet. He had it in a piece of paper, I guess, he lost like 8 years ago. Anytime now. A clear winner in the debate of which Star Wars trilogy was the worst. Oh damn. Yes, I remember. Simpler time. It was an argument from a more civilized time. I like how they diversified in the new Star Wars films, but all aside, all of the characters feel too plasticky. Like the directors were too afraid to have the characters have an insecurity or soft spot, weakness. We see Luke try to conquer his cockiness and temper. We see him fail and suffer the consequences, but we also see him succeed. His success make him a hero, but his failures make him human. I really wished they would have done something similar with the Princess Leia character, although her being dead doesn't help, or even Rey. Ray never fails to deliver, which causes us to believe, I'm nothing like her, I can't do that. It just doesn't feel authentic.